definition we saw, what is the definition of economic development. Then we studied about the features of developing economy, the difference between economic development, economic growth, or economic, you can say, progress. Both the words are same, growth and progress is the economics. Then later on we saw what are the methods through which we can do the allocation of different resources. In last lecture, when I was explaining about different, you can say, allocation of resources at that time, some of the ideas I gave about methods. Three methods are there in your textbook, that is market mechanism, a capitalist system, second one is social system, a socialist system, and third one is mixed economy. Mixed system that is followed by some of the countries of the world. India is a part of that particular system. So here today I will be explaining about different methods of the allocation of resources. From that, first method is market system. Here the word market system, these two words you need to understand in depth, because what do you mean by the word market? Generally, if you see the commerce, if you see the management, if you see the economics, from economics point of view, generally each and every transaction happens in the market. Market does not mean that physically you have to go to the market, you have to buy something from the market, physical goods or services you have to buy. It is not like that. Market can be a virtual one too, because this particular theory has proven by many of the e-commerce giants. Some of them are like Flipkart, Amazon, Alibaba, XYZ. Some of the big giant companies are present who are selling their products online. Now, what do you mean by the word online? That is a part of e-commerce, electronic commerce, about which you will study later on in the commerce if you are going to opt for commerce. So here, market system means what? Market system is that type of system where each and everything revolves around the profit. If you see the scope of profit, you will do that activity. If you don't see the scope of profit, or you can say more profit in that activity, or to do that business, you won't start that business. Though at the long run, it may give you good profit. But whatever activity you are planning to do, it should be giving you something. So here, rather thinking about the society, rather thinking about the welfare of the society at large, everything revolves around the scope of profit. If you want to earn more, you will be having this particular system in your country. Some of the capitalist countries or some of the developed countries of the world, first and foremost one is the United States of America, the US. That country has adopted market system. Generally, capitalist form, everything revolves around the scope of profit. Means property expansion, living standard of the people, countries, national income, everything goes higher in generally capitalist countries. So yes, some of the features we will be studying in depth today. Then yes, benefits. What are the benefits after adopting this particular system in the country? What a benefit a country can get. So here are some of the features of this system. This means market system. Resources allocation, individual or private. Generally resources are allocated to any of the individual members of the family or of the business empire or to the private companies. Now generally what do you mean by the word resource allocation? What are those resources? Generally factors of production we have seen up till now. We have studied in depth. Land, labor, capital and entrepreneurship. These are not the only factors through which we can have our business totally. But yes, these can be considered the resources through which at least we can have the basic things that we can have, that we want in our business. Without land, without capital investment, or you can say without properties, even without money, you cannot have your own business, or you cannot even think about to have the business. Then third one is laborers. Laborers, it is one of the living factors of the production. Because if you are going to have ample numbers of machines in your factory, in your company, but there has to be a person who can operate those machines. Now, to have that particular type of person, that particular there is no information available in economics about the charity. Because if you are going to do charity, you will hardly get something in return. And that should not even be there in your mind if you are doing the charity, that yes, you will get something in return. Because you are not doing that activity with the intention to get something back to whom you are giving something. So here it is not about charity, it is not about illegal activities, or you can say terrorism you won't do, kidnapping you won't do, murder you won't do, theft you won't do. So yes, these are some of the activities which are illegal in nature. Though you will earn more if you are going to do these activities, but these are not considered in economics. So yes, profit-oriented activities will only be coming in economics and especially in market system, because the word itself is saying capitalist system. Wherever you see the capital generation, there you will have your money invested. Third one is opportunity of choice. Now we are consumers or customers, they are given the choice, because there is not just only one person who is selling the product or products in the market. There are more members in the market who are selling different products or who are selling the same products, maybe at different prices. So here opportunity of choice is there with consumers or customers. They will be given a lot of choices, and from those choices, among those things, they will buy what they want. So their wish, their need will be fulfilled properly with the choice, option of choice. Next is no government interference. Now this is quite important feature to understand properly. Here if we are talking about profit, then generally some of the times what happens, producers, manufacturers, they may charge more of different products, which may be posted low to them, or its costing may be low to them, but then to get proper profit, to get more profit, they are selling those products at higher rate. And because of that, because of that intention to get more profit, some of the times what happens, black marketing may be generated. Some of the times consumers may be cheated by taking more price of the product from them. So here, because of the no interference of the government, generally producers, generally manufacturers, they are having free hands to do whatever activity they want, to charge whatever amount they want from the people, from the consumers. So there is lack of government's interference in this system. It is not a negative point that I am explaining, but generally if you talk about government interference, then it can be seen from that aspect that here paperwork is very less. Generally government does not hinder you, does not create any kind of obstacles in your path to have your own business. Paperwork may become very less, or you can say to get the permit to have your own business becomes easy in market system, because whatever activity you will do, you will do that legally. Second one, you will do that to earn something in return. Third one, if you are going to earn profit, you will pay your taxes, and if you are going to pay taxes regularly, even government will get its income. So here everything revolves around profit at last. Everybody will be getting something, if not exactly, but something in return. Though government, or you can say, though government is not interfering, but yes, indirectly it will get something in return. Fifth, economic decision according to the price. Here, whatever economic decision is taken, economic decision means related to the expansion, or you can say related to have other activities, related to have other businesses. Generally, all those decisions are taken, whether to increase price of the product, whether to decrease price of that product. Generally, all those decisions are taken by keeping price mechanism in mind. Generally, if they want to have more businesses in the same line, then generally they will also think that, are they going to have more profit in future? Are they going to get more money in future so that they can have expansion or they can enlarge their business? So all those activities are done, all the economic activities are done by keeping price mechanism in mind. So research. Till its last point, those resources will be utilized because they are the sole people. They are the only people who are going to have loss or they are going to have the profit. If there is a loss, they will bear it. If there is a profit, they will have it on their own. If there is a joint firm, or you can say, if many partners are there in the same business, then yes, profit will be distributed among them. If there is a loss, if the loss has occurred to them, then yes, loss will also be divided among them. Whatever is there, they will utilize that properly and fully because they will bear whatever will come to them. Next one is abundant production. Abundant means what? Whatever production they will do, they will utilize those resources fully. So abundance is there, means too much quantity, large quantity of production may be seen. Because generally when you see that some of the firms, some of the companies work in shifts. Shifts means those companies never stop doing production. They work in shifts. Night shift is there, mid or afternoon shift is there, morning shift is there, general shift is there. So in different shifts, different employees, different laborers work. Means what? They are going to utilize some of the machineries, some of the resources to its fullest extent. Next is new invention and exploration or creation is carried out on the daily basis. Now, because of this profit mechanism that they are going to keep in their mind, everything will be invented. Whatever new things will be there in the market, they must have done the research work on that. So, for that reason, they are having R&D, Research and Development Department, or you can say R&D, Research and Development, you can say unit into their companies. Generally, that unit looks after different inventions they can do, that they can do, or different explorations that they can do for their products. So, generally, because of this invention, even economic growth can become faster. Next one is competition factor. Now, the way I say it, here not only one producer is available to the consumers or to the customers. There are many people who are making different things or different products, or they may be making the same products at different prices. So, here competition is there between two producers, between two manufacturers. So, here generally because of the competition factor, customers will be benefited. There will be no situation of monopoly in the market. Generally, if there is a monopoly in limitations, we will see one of the topics. So, competition, because of this competition factor, prices generally do not get higher in this market mechanism. It is also like a protective measure that is guiding consumers or customers, that is looking after their rights, basic rights or consumer rights. So these are the two topics that we have covered today, that is features of market system, and second one is benefits of or advantages of market system. I hope